Learning by doing, okay.
Classroom is more sort of a person giving a lecture, but workshop is more interactive.
More interactive, yes.
More practical.
More practical, okay. Anybody else?
So the class could be divided into groups and the moderator would read to each and each group and discuss what they are doing.
Yeah, absolutely. Typical MBA answers is what I'm getting. This is what actually happens when you are surrounded by such intellectuals. But I was expecting a very simple answer. A classroom is, I differentiate them on the basis of the purpose they serve. The purpose of a classroom is to make you fall asleep, while the purpose of a workshop is to awaken you to certain possibilities that exist for you. And I just hope that during the next 60 minutes, through my words and my presentation, I manage to wake up certain possibilities that exist for you. And I will do so by telling you something about me. And more than that, I want to set certain premise for this talk. You know what? There are all 50 people sitting in this room. Each and every one of you wants to become something in life. Even the most intelligent person, now you might say, sir, this is really very obvious, or Siddharth, this is really very obvious. Tell me something new. I really want to hear something earth-shattering, wherein when you say that, you know, some lights just lit up. Next 60 minutes are not about that, but they are certainly about lighting up the lights over here, because most of the times we generally miss the obvious. So each and every individual in this room wants to become something, yes or no? Yes or no? I'm a parasite, I just need energy from the audience. Yes or no?
Yes.
And you can shout, you can talk, and just for the next 1 hour, I just want you to just shed off your MBA image, wherein all that you are taught is to sit sophisticated in a very sophisticated manner in the classroom, where the professor is actually doing the talking and talk about the numbers and how that graph is exactly going to look like. This is not about graphs. This is not about graphs. This is about thing called emotions. And I'm a person who's completely driven by emotions. And this is, I today through my presentation, that is the part of you, that emotional part of you, which I really want to touch upon, which unfortunately or fortunately has been covered by the jackets of formalities. You know, when you are in a business school, you are taught a lot of sophistication, you are taught to behave yourself and groom yourself and carry yourself in a certain manner. I've done that with myself prior to starting on my own. I've worked with McKinsey & Company for 4 years in their strategic research vertical, and thereafter I just left, and you will get to know why. But I want to share this, wake you up to the possibilities and the potential that actually exists for you by telling you three things, three times how I got cornered in life and what did I learn. And so these are the three phases of my life. And these three phases are, the first phase is the school, the second phase is the youth, and the third phase is the office. I would need some help. Can we just do away with this table, or is this fixed?
No.
If we can just...